science. In this video, we are going to discuss about three topics. They are boiling, melting and freezing. These three topics are the last topics of our first lesson, heat. Let me explain the first topic, boiling. I'll explain this topic by taking a small activity. Take a beaker full of water and place it on a Bunsen burner and place a thermometer and keep a thermometer into the water and notice the temperature readings for every 2 minutes. Children, can you observe any change in the thermometer? Any change in the value of the thermometer? Yes, the temperature increases. Okay, when we supply the heat energy continuously, automatically the temperature in the thermometer, the temperature of the thermometer also increases. Okay, when does the temperature rise stop? When, yes, the rising temperature rises continuously till it reaches 100 degrees Celsius. At 100 degrees Celsius, even though if you supply heat energy continuously, but the temperature reading, the temperature does not increase further. And also, the water bubbles also, the bubbles also formed on the surface of the water, and we will also observe the bubbling on the surface of the water. Okay, why? Why? Because water is a solution. So many impurities are dissolved in water. Similarly, gases also dissolve in water. When we heat the water, the gases loses its solubility. What is meant by solubility? The ability to dissolve, especially in water. Okay, when we heat the water, the gases loses its dissolving capacity and the dissolving ability. Okay, so as a result, the bubbles of gas forms in the liquid. The bubbles of gas forms in the liquid. These bubbles completely filled with a saturated vapor. These bubbles filled with saturated vapor. What is meant by saturated vapor, ma? Saturated vapor is a state where the system holding the maximum amount of water in vapor is called as saturated vapor. Okay, at constant temperature and pressure. So that state is nothing but saturated vapor state. Okay, so when we supply the heat energy continuously, the pressure of the saturated vapor increases and it is equal to, and at certain temperature, it is equal to atmospheric pressure. When the pressure in the saturated vapor is equal to the atmospheric pressure, as a result, these bubbles rises rapidly and they reaches the surface of the water and they collapse at the surface and the water molecules escape from the liquid, from the bubble. Okay, so this process of converting liquid to vapor continues as long as we supply the heat energy. This appears as boiling of water. Okay, and next, from this, now I'll explain the definition of boiling. Boiling is the change of phase from liquid to vapor at constant temperature and pressure. At constant temperature and pressure. So, this constant temperature is nothing but boiling point. This constant temperature is also called as boiling point of liquid. Okay, what is the definition, ma? Boiling is the change of phase from liquid to vapor at constant temperature and pressure. In evaporation, already we discussed it. Evaporation takes place at any temperature, but boiling takes place at definite temperature, that temperature is called as boiling point. So in this activity, what we observed, ma'am? The temperature, when we supply the heat energy, the temperature of the liquid rises continuously till it reaches the 100 degrees Celsius. After 100 degrees Celsius, even though we supply the heat energy continuously, the temperature doesn't change further. Why? And where does the heat energy supplied go? Okay, I'll explain it clearly to your children. Children, already you know the three states of the matter. They are solids, liquids and gases. Generally, in solids, the bond strength between the molecules is very high and the distance between the molecules is also negligible. So, they are tightly packed. Okay, similarly, in liquids, the bond strength between the molecules is less than the solids and the distance between the molecules is higher than the solids. So, in gases, the bond strength between molecules is very, very less than liquids and solids. Similarly, the bond length, similarly the distance between the molecules, is also very high than water, liquids and solids. Okay, so here when we supply the heat energy continuously to the water utilizes this energy to break the bond strength and to change, for changing its state from liquid to vapor. Okay, when we supply the heat energy continuously, the water utilizes this heat energy to change its states from liquid to vapor. Okay, so this heat energy is nothing but latent heat of vaporization. Children, what is meant by latent heat of vaporization? The amount of heat energy required to change the 1 gram of liquid to gas is called as latent heat of vaporization. What is the difference between specific heat and latent heat of vaporization? Specific heat means, specific heat is also a heat energy, supplying the heat energy. See, the amount of heat energy required to rise the temperature just 1 degree Celsius, it is called as specific heat. But here, the amount of heat energy required to change the state, to change the substance from one state to another state, it is nothing but latent heat. Okay, here when the, here the liquid is changing, here the liquid is changing from liquid state to vapor. So that heat energy is nothing but latent heat of vaporization. We will represent this latent heat of vaporization with a symbol L, capital L. The formula for latent heat of vaporization is Q by M. Q is nothing but heat energy and M is mass. And now, what are the SI units and CGS units of the latent heat, ma'am? Q, what are SI units of, CGS units of mass? Grams. The CGS units of heat energy is calorie and the CGS units of mass is grams. So in CGS system, the units of latent heat is, latent heat of vaporization is calorie per gram. And what are the SI units? SI units of heat energy is joules and SI units of mass is kg. So, the SI units of latent heat of vaporization is joule per kg. Children, by this activity, can you guess what is the boiling point of the water? Yes, 100 degrees Celsius. Then, okay, what is the value of 100 degree Celsius in Kelvin? Right, already we know the formula how to convert the degree Celsius into Kelvin. So Kelvin is equal to 273 less degree Celsius, means K is equal to 273 plus 100 degree Celsius, means K is equal to 373 Kelvin. 373 means 100 degree Celsius is equal to 373 Kelvin. So the boiling point of water is either 100 degree Celsius or 373 Kelvins. Similarly, the latent heat of vaporization of water, the value of the latent heat of vaporization of water is 540 calorie per gram. 540 calorie per gram. Okay, children, this is about boiling. And our next topic is melting. Take some ice cubes in a beaker and insert a thermometer into ice cubes and note down the readings of temperature. Next, place the beaker on Bunsen burner and you have to note down the values of the thermometer for every 1 minute till the total ice cubes gets melts into water. Okay, next, initially what we'll notice, ma'am, the temperature of the ice cubes is 0 degree Celsius or below 0 degree Celsius. For example, if you assume the temperature of these ice cubes is below 0 degree Celsius. Okay, the temperature of these ice cubes is below 0 degree Celsius. So, when we supply the heat energy to the ice cubes, in this case, the heat energy rises till it reaches the 0 degree Celsius. The heat energy of the thermometer rises till it reaches 0 degree Celsius. After 0 degree Celsius, it remains constant till the total ice cubes melts into water. Okay, so now where does the heat energy supplied go? Already I explained you in boiling. Here ice is a solid. Yes or no, ma? Here ice is a solid. So the solid, the molecules in the solid are tightly packed. Okay, and when we supply the heat energy to these molecules, so the molecules in the ice utilizes this heat energy to change their state, to break the bonds. Okay, to break the bonds for changing their state from solid to liquid. Okay, when we supply the heat energy continuously to the ice, the molecules of the ice utilizes this heat energy to break the bonds for changing their state from solid to liquid. So, at 0 degree Celsius, the total ice gets melts into water at constant temperature, 0 degree Celsius. Okay, the total ice melts into water. So, the amount of heat energy what we are supplying to convert 1 gram of ice to water is called as latent heat of fusion. Okay, we represent latent heat of fusion with a symbol LF, and the formula is also same to as latent heat of vaporization. It is Q by M, and the Celsius units are calorie per gram and SI units are joule per kg. Okay, so the melting, what is mean by melting? Melting means the change of phase. Change of phase from solid to
liquid at constant temperature. At constant temperature, this is known as melting. In the melting, the solid is changing into, the state of solid is changing into liquid at constant temperature. Here the constant temperature means melting point. We call this constant temperature as melting point. In boiling point, in the topic of boiling, the constant temperature means boiling point, but in melting, here the constant temperature means melting point. So the melting point of ice, so what is the melting point of ice, ma? 0 degree Celsius. At 0 degree Celsius, even though if you supply heat energy continuously, the temperature does not change when the ice completely melts into water. Okay, and now what is the value of 0 degree Celsius in kelvins? Okay, so already we know Kelvin is equal to 273 plus 0 degree Celsius, that is equal to 273 plus 0 Celsius is equal to 273, means the melting point of ice is either 0 degree Celsius or 273 Kelvin. Similarly, the latent heat of fusion of ice is 80 calorie per gram. The value of latent heat of fusion of ice is 80 calorie per gram. Latent heat of vaporization of water is 540 calorie per gram. Okay, children, now I'm going to explain a problem related to boiling and melting. So first look at the problem. Calculate required heat energy to change required heat energy. Here we are finding the heat energy to change 12 grams of ice. 12 grams of ice at minus 10 degrees Celsius into water vapor at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, here we are finding the heat energy to change 12 grams of ice at minus 10 degrees Celsius in Celsius to water vapor at 100 degrees Celsius. So for your better understanding, in boiling and melting we discussed some temperature changes. I will explain that changes in graphical representation. Children, look here. Take x axis and y axis. So take heat on x axis and temperature on y axis. Why we are considering heat on x axis and temperature on y axis? Here heat is a independent variable. So that's why here we are taking heat on x axis and temperature is a dependent quantity. So we are taking temperature on y axis. Okay, so for example, in the case of melting, what we have taken, we have taken initially the temperature is below 0 degree Celsius. Okay, in melting initially we considered the temperature as below 0 degree Celsius. Okay, so for example, you assume the temperature as minus 5 degree Celsius. You assume the temperature as minus 5 degree Celsius. So what are the changes we observed? So at 5 degree Celsius, the temperature, when we supply the heat energy, the temperature rises till it reaches 0 degree Celsius. Okay, till 0 degree Celsius. And from here onwards, the temperature remains constant till the total ice melts into water. The total ice melts into water. So here the total ice converted into water. When from this state
the temperature starts again rising till boiling point. Okay, already we know the boiling point of water. The boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. So the temperature rises till 100 degrees Celsius. So after when it reaches at 100 degrees Celsius, again the temperature remains constant. 100 degrees Celsius water and the temperature remains constant, and slowly when we supply the heat energy continuously, by taking that heat energy, the water changes its state from water liquid to vapor. Okay, so 100 degrees Celsius and vapor. Okay children, 100 degrees Celsius vapor. So these are the stages we discussed. Okay, so initially below 0 degrees Celsius to the temperature rises up to 0 degrees Celsius. Next, from 0 degrees Celsius ice to 0 degrees Celsius of water, the temperature remains constant. And again, from water 0 degrees Celsius to, the temperature rises till 100 degrees Celsius. After 100 degrees Celsius, the temperature again remains constant. So this water, by taking that heat energy, they starts evaporating. Okay, now coming to the point. Here, look here children, 12 grams of ice means the mass of the ice. Mass is equal to 12 grams. Ice at 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, initially here we have considered 5 degrees. Instead of that, you will consider 10 degrees Celsius. Okay, by solving this problem from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius of vapor, what is the heat energy for changing from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius? What is the, how much of heat energy is required? Okay, this is our sum. For solving this problem, we need to do this sum in four stages. They are, first stage is from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius, and second stage is 0 degrees Celsius to Celsius ice to 0 degrees Celsius of water, and third stage is heat required to change from 0 degrees Celsius of water to 100 degrees Celsius of water, and fourth stage is 100 degrees Celsius of heat energy required to change 100 degrees Celsius of water to 100 degrees Celsius of vapor. Okay, if we find the heat energy in these four cases, after when we add these four cases, we will get the total heat energy required to change from minus 10 degrees Celsius into water vapor at 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, let me explain the stage 1. Stage 1. Children, in this stage, you will observe minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. Here, that only the temperature only increased. There is no change in the state. In minus 10 degrees Celsius also, it is ice. In 0 degrees Celsius also, the substance is ice only. Okay? So, here only the temperature only changed, but the state was not changed. Okay, so that's why only if the temperature rises, we use a formula, heat energy required to rise minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius ice. Okay, formula is Q is equal to Ms delta T. Here only temperature only rising. At that time, we will use this formula. Okay. Look here children. Q1.
This is stage 1 only, so that's why I'm considering it as Q1. What is the mass of the ice cubes, ma'am? The mass of the ice cubes is 12 grams. 12 into, what is the specific heat of ice? Specific heat of the ice is 0.5 grams. S is equal to 0.5 grams. So, I'm writing 0.5 as 1 by 2. Into delta T. Delta T means here the temperature changes. Minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius. So, T2, consider this as T1 and 0 degrees Celsius as T2. So, formula is T2 minus T1 means 0 degrees Celsius minus 10. So, Q1 is equal to 12 into 1 by 2 into minus plus 10. 0 plus 10, 0. 10 only. Okay? 6 times. So, Q1 is equal to 6 into 10, 60 calories. Okay? So, first stage, how much of heat energy we spent to change from minus 10 degrees to 0 degrees Celsius is 60 calories. Okay, and next our second stage, heat energy required to convert 0 degree Celsius ice to 0 degree Celsius water. Okay, so it is Q2. Children, in this case, here the ice convert into water. So here the stage is changing. So when the stage changes, the required heat energy, we call it as a latent heat. Okay, now already you know, what is the formula for latent heat, ma? L is equal to Q by M. From this formula, what is Q? Q is equal to LM. Okay, or Q2 is equal to ML. Okay, what is the mass of the ice? 12 into, here ice is converting into water. So, fusion. Here it is not a vaporized state. This is the stage of fusion. So, this is latent heat of fusion into LF. That is equal to 12 into latent heat of fusion of ice is equal to, means LF is equal to 80 calorie per gram. So, 18. 12 8 zone 96. 0. 960 calories. This is stage 2. And next stage 3. In stage 3, here the temperature rises from 0 degree Celsius of water to 100 degree Celsius of water. So, for rising from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius, what is the heat energy required? Required heat energy to rise 0 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius of water to 100 degree Celsius of water. Children, in this third stage, only the temperature only changing. So, there is no change in the state. So, in this case, we will use formula Q3 is equal to ms delta T. So, mass is 12. And specific heat of water is 1. Already we know it. and change in temperature. Here consider 0 degree Celsius as T1 and 100 degrees as T2. Change in temperature is T2 minus T1. So 100 minus 0. So 1200 calories. This is stage 3. And next, in stage 3, Q3 is equal to 1200 calories. And in stage 2, already we did, Q2 is equal to 960 calories. And our next one is the stage 4. So, in stage 4, the required heat energy to convert 100 degrees Celsius of water to 100 degrees Celsius of water vapor. So here the temperature is not increasing. Here what happening? Here the state is changing. So at that time we will use formula QV. Means here the water is changing into vapor. So latent heat of vaporization. So Q4 is equal to M into LV. So mass is equal to 12. And similarly, the value of latent heat of vaporization is 540 calorie per gram. So substitute this value here, 540 calories. So now multiply these two, 540 into 12, 0 into 12, 0, 4 12s are 48, 5 12s are 60, 60 plus 4, 6480 calories. So now write this value in case 4. So here Q4 is equal to 6480 calories. Okay, so now the total energy, the total energy required to convert 12 grams of ice at minus 10 degrees Celsius into vapor at 100 degrees Celsius. So, total heat energy required is equal to Q is equal to Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4. Okay, so what is the value of Q1 more here? Q1 is equal to 60 calories for changing from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 0 degrees Celsius of ice. So the required heat energy is 60 calories plus Q2 is 9960 calories plus Q3 is 1200 calories and Q4 is 6480. Add this total mark. Zero, 6 plus 6, 12. 12 plus 8, 20. So 9 plus 2, 11. 11 plus 4, 15. 15 plus 2, 17. 6, 1, 7, 8. 8,700. So 8,700 calories. This is our final answer. So the total amount of heat energy required to convert 12 grams of ice at minus 10 degrees Celsius into water vapor at 100 degrees Celsius is 8700 calories. Okay, children, our last topic is freezing. Generally, in winter season, in our houses, we will observe, especially coconut oil, ghee, these type of liquids convert to solid. Is it right? Okay. Next term, if you place water into deep freezer of refrigerator, after few hours, it converts into ice. Why? Why the liquids are converting as solids? Okay, now I'll explain. For example, if you take water, the initial temperature of the water is more than the ice cube. Why? Because of here, from water to ice cube, what is the difference we observed? The temperature decreases. Yes or no, ma'am? Here the temperature is decreasing. So when the temperature decreases, the kinetic energy of the molecules also decreases. So the internal energy of the water decreases. As a result, the liquid converts into solid. Children, by this knowledge, can you tell the definition of freezing? Okay, freezing is the change of phase from liquid to solid. Liquid to solid by losing some of its energy. After losing some energy, the substance changing from liquid phase to solid phase. This is nothing but freezing. Freezing takes place at 0 degrees Celsius temperature and 1 atmospheric pressure. Okay, now I'll explain this freezing by taking one more activity. Children, take a glass bottle and which contains a tight lid and fill the bottle completely without any gaps. And now keep the lid tightly in such a way the water doesn't come out from the bottle. Now keep the bottle into deep freezer of refrigerator for few hours. So after few hours, take the bottle out from the refrigerator. What you'll notice? We will notice that the cracks are formed on the bottle. Why? Why? Because of the volume of the ice. When we decrease the temperature, now we are keeping the bottle into deep freezer of refrigerator. So here the temperature decreasing. So when the temperature decreases, the liquid converts into solid. So the solid means the ice contains more volume than the water. So the ice starts expanding. So the bottle gives cracks. Children, in 9th class already you studied ice floats on water. Why? Yes, the density of the ice is less than the water. So by these two cases, what we understood, ma'am, what we are concluding here? The volume of the ice is more than the volume of the water. And the density of the ice is less than the density of the water. So this is a small information about freezing. Children, in this video, we discussed three topics clearly. They are boiling, melting and freezing. With these topics, we completed our first lesson, heat. I hope you are very perfect and very clear each and every topic in this lesson. So, please subscribe my channel for getting further chapters. Thank you.